So good morning once again. Let's start with the discussion of the questions of part one. Questions given on page 17 in your textbook. In the box, right side, top right side of page 17. Let's start with question number one. Ashwinder. Ashwinder, please unmute yourself, beta. Ashwinder, please unmute and switch on your video.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, switch on your video also.
Ma'am, I can't. I can't switch right.
Okay, read the first question. Read the first question and answer.
What is Sahib looking for in the garbage dumps? Where is he and where has he come from?
Yes. What is Sahib looking for in the garbage dumps?
Yes. Ma'am, Sahib is looking for coins, rupee notes, and any other useful objects in the garbage dumps.
What is the exact word used in the chapter for
Sahib
that?
And his family have migrated to
Please answer the question which I'm asking. Just wait.
Ma'am, for what?
What is the exact word used in the chapter looking for? Sahib is looking for gold in the garbage dumps. Okay, which you have explained the meaning. That is something precious which they can sell and get some money out of that. Okay. Yes. Next part of the question. Where is he and where has he come from? Medical 11, roll number Muskan. Second part. Roll number 11, medical, Muskan. Please unmute yourself. Dipinder from medical, roll number 20. Dipinder.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Second part of the first question. Where is he and where has he come from? Beta, please don't waste the time. All of you must be ready when your name is announced. Dipinder, are you going to answer? Yes, Jasmine from medical, roll number 5.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, second part of the first question.
Ma'am, Sahib and his family have come from Simapuri looking for a source of living so that from garbage they can find some coins, rupee notes or any useful things, and they had set up now in Delhi.
From where have they come?
Ma'am,
Dhaka. Yes, he is in the neighborhood of the author. Now in Simapuri in Delhi, and he has come from Bangladesh. He came along with his mother in 1971, and his house was set amidst the green fields of Dhaka. Storms swept away their fields and homes, so they left the area. Coming to the next question, Kanika.
What explanations does the
object... your video? Please switch on your video. Yes, beta. Question number two.
What explanation? The author comes across many shoeless, ragpicker children in her neighborhood. And according to her, one explanation of this habit of remaining barefoot is that it is a tradition among the poor children of this country. And however, the author quickly mentions that calling it is tradition could be just a means of justification of the utter destitution.
Anything else the author has given? She wonders for something. Yes, Samvet Tugal, Anything you want to add? Samvet Dugal?
Ma'am, I have joined now.
Okay. Gurveer Kaur? Gurveer Kaur?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, anything you want to add in the answer of the...
Yes, ma'am.
Anika? Yes?
For them and for their community, buying shoes, not buying shoes has become a tradition because most of them can't afford them, and also they prefer having proper meals rather than buying expensive things. So they have made it a tradition that walk barefooting, barefootedly.
One explanation offered by the author is that it is a tradition to stay barefoot. It's not lack of money. He wonders if this is only an excuse to explain away a perpetual state of poverty. She got surprised with this, whether this is an excuse just to explain about their perpetual or the continuous state of poverty. He also remembers about the story of a poor boy who prayed to goddess for a pair of shoes, the priest's son. Okay. Then coming to the next question, Anirudh from commerce, please unmute yourself. Anirudh or Gurnoor from non-medical, 19 roll number, Gurnoor. Please beta quickly unmute yourself. Sania from commerce. Yes, beta.
Is Sahib happy working at the tea stall? Explain.
Yes.
Sahib is not happy working at the tea stall. No doubt he's paid 800 rupees and all his meals, but he has lost his carefree look and the freedom which he used to enjoy earlier. And moreover, the steel canister which he carries is also heavier than the plastic bag which he used to carry earlier. So he's not happy. And
yes, very good. Very good. Freedom. No, Sahib is not happy working at the tea stall because he is no longer his own master now. His face has lost the carefree look. The steel canister seems heavier than the plastic bag he would carry so lightly over his shoulders. The bag was his. The canister belongs to the man who owns the tea shop, though he is being paid 800 rupees regularly and he's getting three time meal, but he is not happy because he has lost his freedom. He's not his own master now. Okay. Now next, Ketan, you are raising hand. Yes, beta. Listen the question.
Ma'am. Listen the question. I want to ask something.
You want to ask something, okay?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, the steel canister seems heavier than the plastic bag he would carry so lightly. Ma'am, iska matlab ye nahi hoga ki jo plastic bag tha wo uska tha isliye usko halka lagta tha.
This can be the thing, but even then, if we go for physically for the weight of the things, the plastic bag will be lighter than the steel canister. It's automatic. Na ki agar steel ka koi bartan hai, container hai, to wo heavy hoga. Plastic bag jo hai wo light hoga. Dono tarah se hi theek hai ye. उसका अपना था इसलिए भी उसको इजी लगता था उसको कैरी करना कंफर्टेबल था एंड ही फील्स प्राउड ऑफ हिज ओन थिंग वेयर एज दैट कनिस्टर वाज ऑफ समवन एल्स इट वाज नॉट हिज ओन अदरवाइज इट वाज हैवी आल्सो ओके नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन लेट मी आस्क सम ऑफ द मोर क्वेश्चंस रिलेटिंग टू दिस पार्ट देन वी विल मूव फॉर द सेकंड पार्ट यस केतन विल यू आंसर हु वाज साहिब And what was he doing and why? Who was Sahib?
And?
Yes?
And ke baad kya?
Who was Sahib? What was he doing and why?
Sahib was a boy who was a garbage picker.
You can add some adjective that Sahib was a young boy of school going age. Yes? What was he doing?
He was rag picking when the author saw him. And he was very anxious and curious to go to school. And when the author gave him some encouragement to go to school, he shows his interest in going to school. And but author can't help him at that
yes,
time.
Yes, he was looking for gold in the garbage dumps of the big city.
He had left his house in Dhaka, Bangladesh, and came to the big city in search of living. He has nothing else to do but rag picking. Okay? Just
Sahib, full name is Sahib A. Alam, and the meaning is the Lord of Universe.
Yes, his full name is Sahib A. Alam, and it means the Lord of the Universe. Does he know it? Does he know it? Yes, Khushi beta? Does he know it?
Yes, yes, ma'am. No, no.
About the meaning of his name.
He don't know the meaning of his name.
Is there any irony in the situation given?
Irony.
Is there any irony given in the situation or with the name?
Sorry, ma'am. I don't know this.
Okay. Yes, Gurveer, would you like to explain it?
Yes, ma'am. So, Sahib's full name was Sahib-e Alam, and it meant Lord of the Universe. So, he doesn't know the meaning of his name. And it was good for him because if he knew, it would have been very hard for him believing it. Yes. Because irony of situation was that he was living in a completely opposite situation. He was a rag picker and his community was poverty stricken. So his situation was completely opposite from his meaning of his name.
Very good explanation. Now coming to the next, I have one more hand raised. There was one student who has lowered it now. I was getting one hand raised here. Coming to the next question, please raise your hands, those who are willing to answer instead of speaking the names again and again. Prabjot, are you there in the meeting, beta? Evelyn Kaur. Yes, the name was Kanav Batra.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Evelyn, beta, first you answer. How does the author focus on the perpetual state of poverty of the children not wearing footwear? Yes, Evelyn Bita, please unmute yourself. How does the author focus on the perpetual state of poverty of the children not wearing footwear?
He focuses on the Simapuri place where all the rag pickers and all live.
Yes. What does she explain about the perpetual state of poverty? What is the matter or the idea that is related with this?
She explains the situation in the Simapuri, that structure of muds with roof of tents devoid of
sewage. Where this statement is given? What topic is being discussed at that time? Perpetual state of poverty phrase jo hai, kaha use kiya gaya? What condition or what problem was being discussed at that time? That was about the children of this area not wearing footwear.
Sorry, ma'am.
The author notices that most of the young children engaged in the rag picking are not wearing footwear. Some of them do not have chappals. Others want to wear shoes. Some say it is tradition to say barefoot. To the author, it seems lack of money. And poverty forces them to walk without footwear. Okay. Next, Kanav Batra. Kanav Batra, please unmute yourself, beta.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, your question is, where does the author find Sahib one winter morning?
The author finds Sahib in the, near, near the garbage dumps in his neighborhood?
No. One winter morning, particular mention kiya hua hai beta. Where does the author find Sahib one winter morning? And what explanation does Sahib offer? Winter morning mein particular kahan mein author milta hai usko? The author finds Sahib standing by the fenced gate of a neighborhood club. You remember?
Yes, ma'am.
Standing by the fenced gate of a neighborhood club. And what explanation is being given there? He's watching. What is he watching at that time, standing near the gate? What is he watching? Yes, anyone else? Please raise your hand quickly. Ashwinder, Ashwinder, roll number 4, please unmute yourself.
Ma'am, yes. Ma'am, Sahib stood by the fenced gate of the neighborhood club to watch the game of tennis. Yes. He watched two young men dressed in white playing tennis. He liked the game, but the game he watched so intensely was out of reach, but he was content to watch it standing behind the fence.
Yes. He was content to watch it standing behind the fence. He goes inside when no one is around and he uses the swing there. When he goes inside, when no one is there, gatekeeper allows him to go in and he uses the swings there at that time. Okay. Next question. Please raise your hands. Savraj, Sanjana, Kashvi. Beta, you have to answer. Only then I'll be able to mark your speaking and listening skills marks. Otherwise, it will be very difficult for me to mark and then you can lose marks there. If I'm not able to make proper judgment, you will lose the marks there. So it is better to participate in the interaction and the discussion part. Yes, raise your hands for the next question. What job did Sahib take up? What job did Sahib take up? Yes, Himani? Himani, Sanjana, Kashvi, Manya, anyone? Again and again, I can see only three hands, Gurveer, Khushi, and Jasmine. Please, the rest of the students, those who have not got the turn, raise your hands and come forward. Beta, you have to answer. Only then the marks will be given to you. Hena Taneja, yes, beta. Good. Hena Taneja.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, Sahib took a job at a tea stall where he used to earn 800 rupees per month.
Yes. Was he happy there?
No, he was not happy there because now he was, now his freedom was not...
He had lost,
his freedom
and he was not his own master. This is the same question that we discussed already in the textbook. Okay. Now coming to the next question, Himani beta, you raise your hand, please unmute yourself. Himani.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Your question is, how has a dream come true for Sahib? How has a dream come true for Sahib?
Ma'am, Sahib is wearing the discarded tennis shoes.
Yes.
For one who has walked barefoot, even shoes with the hole is a dream come true.
Yes, Sahib is wearing discarded tennis shoes. One of them has a hole. Sahib does not bother about the hole. For one who has walked barefoot, even shoes with the hole is a dream come true. And one thing which is out of his reach, what is that? Himani, anything that is out of his reach? Yes. What is out of his reach? Sanya?
The game of tennis, which he is watching so intently.
Yes, the game he is watching so intently, tennis game, is out of his reach. Okay. Now, the last question. Please, some more students should raise their hands. I want participation from the other students. We are not going to go for the next part today. Only the discussion part is there today. And you have to participate in the discussions every time after the ending of the chapter so that some judgment can be made according to your speaking and listening skills. Yes, Savraj. Savraj, 65 roll number in commerce. Yes, beta. Your question is, how does Sahib's life change when he starts working at the tea stall? How does Sahib's life change when he starts working at the tea stall? Yes, Savraj beta, unmute yourself. Yes, Harshita Gandhi.
Earlier Sahib was his own master. Now he has become a servant. Moreover, he has also lost his freedom.
Yes. Though he is getting a regular income, he is paid 800 rupees and all his meals.
And he also get all the meals, but he was not happy at all.
He has lost the carefree look, and that steel canister in his hand now seems a burden. And he is no longer his own master now. It's one and the same answer only we are discussing again and again, but the question is different. Okay. Now coming to the next part. Any doubt to anyone for this part before I start with the next part? We are left only with the 4 to 5 minutes. Let's start with that part. If you have any doubt, you can raise your hands still if there is any problem. But please, beta, be particular. You have to participate in the discussions. Only then marks will be given to you out of 20. You know that you have 20 marks for your listening and speaking skills in the board. And that will be given if you participate in the discussions. Otherwise, I'll not be able to make proper judgment. Yes, coming to the second part, I want to drive a car. Is the screen visible, beta?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes. Ma'am.
Mukesh, we had the introduction yesterday that in this part, we are going to have the description about the bangle making industry in Firozabad. And there is a child named Mukesh who has a desire, who is shown as a very enthusiastic and desirous to, child, who insists on being his own master. And he says, I'll be a motor mechanic. He announces he wants to learn for motor mechanic work and wants to become a motor mechanic, wants to drive a car. Do you know anything about cars? I ask. Now the author asks this boy if he wants to learn something or if he knows anything about the cars. I will learn to drive a car, he answers, looking straight into my eyes. His dream looms like a mirage amidst the dust of streets that fill his town, Firozabad. Please underline this line, famous for its bangles. And what he answers, he says that I will learn to drive a car. He was looking directly into the eyes of the author, showing the feeling of his dream and desire. His dream looms like a mirage amidst the dust of streams that fill his town, Firozabad, famous for its bangles. But the author feels that his dream is just like a mirage. Mirage hota jaise ek mirror mein ek reflection nazar aata hai. That is, his dream is hanging just like a mirror, only giving the reflection amidst the dust of streams, streets. Firozabad ki galiyan jo ki dust se bhari hui hain, jahan par ki bangles banai jati hain, it is famous for the glass bangles. And she feels that his dream is only hanging just like a mirror, just like a reflection in those streets. He will not be able to fulfill his desire. Every other family in Firozabad is engaged in making bangles. That means all the families living in Firozabad are busy. Engaged means busy in making the bangles. It is a center of India's glass blowing industries where families have spent generations working around furnaces, welding glass, making bangles for all the women in the land. It seems that this is the place where their generations had spent their time. They had been working around the furnaces samajhte ho, bhatti ke charo taraf baithkar unhone continuously apni life mein yahi kaam kiya hai. They are welding glass, matlab jod rahe hain glass ke pieces ko. They are making bangles for all the women in the land. Kis duniya mein, is zameen ke upar jitni women hain unke liye jo kaanch ki bangles banti hain, glass bangles banti hain, that is being made in that area of Firozabad. Now after this we are given the description about Mukesh's family. Mukesh is among them. None of them know that it is illegal for children like him to work in the glass furnaces with high temperature, in dingy cells, without air and light. See the condition in which these people are working. Mukesh's family is one among them, those who are working in the bangle making industry. None of them know that it is illegal. Ki unme se kisi ko nahi pata ki bachchon ke liye aisi industry mein kaam karna jo ki bahut dangerous hai, bahut hazardous hai, that is illegal. Kanuni taur par mana hai to work in the glass furnaces with high temperatures. Bahut high temperature hota wahan par, in dingy cells, aise cells jahan par ki koi ventilation nahi hai, koi hawa ki crossing nahi hai, without air and light. That the law, if enforced, could get him and all those 20,000 children out of the hot furnaces where they slog their daylight hours, often losing the brightness of their eyes. What is the result when they work here? Near about 20,000 children are working there. And if they say they are enforced, if the law enforced them, then these children can be brought out of these hot furnaces and where they are working in the darkness. And what happens at the end? They lose the brightness of their eyes. So we are ending with